Outfront now, CNN legal analyst and former prosecutor Paul Callan and criminal defense attorney Bradfird Cohen, also a former contestant on The Apprentice, a supporter of Donald Trump. Let me just start for both of you, because this is what this comes down to when it comes to Attorney General Sessions. What he said during his confirmation hearing when he was asked what he would do if evidence existed that anyone affiliated with the Trump campaign communicated with the Russian government during the campaign. That was the question. Here's how it went down.
Senator Franken, I'm not aware of any of those activities. I have been called a surrogate at a time or two in that campaign, and I didn't have communications with the Russians, and I'm unable to comment on it.
Okay, now, here is the Attorney General today.
Let me be clear. I never had meetings with Russian operatives or Russian intermediaries about the Trump campaign. My reply to the question of Senator Franken was honest and correct as I understood it at the time.
Paul, do you buy his explanation today, or did he lie to Senator Franken?
I'm really kind of stunned by it, because he said today that the reason he made the mistake is because he was asked about a continuing exchange with the Russians. But Franken didn't ask him about that.
No.
And in fact, his words were, I did not have communications with the Russians. It almost sounds like that statement that was made by President Clinton, I didn't have sexual relations with that woman. And you know, Sessions called for his impeachment when the president made that inaccurate statement. So it's really astonishing that in this press conference, he mischaracterizes his own statement.
Perjury?
I think it's very close to the line, but not over the line of perjury. I think it's misconduct. I think it's arguably unethical conduct, but I think it would be a hard perjury prosecution.
Misconduct, unethical, not true. What do you say, Brad?
I think that his excuse and his reasoning for the answer he gave was very credible. What we saw in that Al Franken exchange was he did mention, if you look at the whole exchange and not just a snippet, he did mention continuing conversations between Russian operatives and people from the Trump campaign. And if you see the whole exchange, if you see it in its totality, he's talking about hacking, he's talking about different things about individuals speaking with the Trump campaign. I could see where that answer makes sense. He's, you know, as his job, in the committee of the Armed Services Committee, in his role, he has contact with ambassadors. This is something that he didn't even think of, because it's not something that had to do with the campaign.
If I could just ask you this, because in his job as Attorney General, he prosecutes perjury cases, and he fills out
this is not perjury.
He fills out his application for the Attorney General job. And he lies in the application. Doesn't that strike you as being kind of misconduct,
Paul,
right at the beginning?
No. Paul, this is not even close to being perjury.
You were on the Celebrity Apprentice, correct? And Donald Trump
I was on the regular apprentice. I appreciate you calling me a celebrity.
Okay.
Just
but
the
Donald,
regular
Donald
apprentice.
Donald Trump fired you, I understand, toward the end of the show. But don't you think he would have fired you sooner if you lied on your application for the show?
Listen, the fact is that he did not lie. This is not a lie. If Al Franken followed up with a question, sir, did you personally have any contact with Russian operatives, Russian ambassadors in your role as a senator and or for the Trump campaign?
Well, he said, did you have any with Russian officials, Brad? The thing is, why, if you were really honest, can we all just say, wouldn't you just say, I did, but it was in my role as armed services. I'll be happy to tell you what I talked about, because clearly today he remembered it all. But by omitting it and acting like it didn't happen at all, it does really raise questions. I mean, wouldn't you acknowledge that, Brad?
No, I don't think so. I really don't. If you look at the totality of it, if you look at it in its whole, not just a snippet of what he said about the exchange between Franken and Sessions, you could see where this answer makes a lot of sense. He is talking about surrogates that had contact, continuing contact with Russian ambassadors or Russian individuals or operatives, and he would not even think of this, because in his
Greg,
role,
he's
he
not.
Turned over.
He says,
wait, let me just make
he
this
says,
one point.
I did
he,
not
he turned
have
over.
Communications with the Russians. Is
yes,
there something you
yes,
don't understand about that?
Yes, but if you see
that?
His whole statement, Paul, if you see his whole statement, he says, I was called a surrogate once, meaning in his role as a surrogate for Trump. That's my understanding
like
of it. And
like,
I think he's
like
believable.
Me. You're a trial lawyer, right? You cross-examine people. Would you use that to impeach?
Yeah, cross-examine everybody.
Would you use that statement in a court of law to impeach a witness who was on the witness stand?
Would I use it to impeach?
Yeah, would you use it against? Would you use it against Sessions if he was on the witness stand in a case that you were trying? Yeah.
Well, that's the
would
whole point, is that Franken should have followed it up.
Of course, use it because it shows he wasn't telling the truth.
I would have used it for a follow-up, Paul. I would have used it for a follow-up question. And my follow-up question would have been, are you saying you did not have any contact with the Russians, either as in your official role or anything else? That would have been the question. You know, Al Franken, during this exchange, says, sir, I'm not an attorney. It's very apparent he's not an attorney because his questions were horrible. His question wasn't exact. His question was answered. And I think that at the time he answered that question, he answered it in the best way he could.
Because he wasn't paying attention to the questions.
All right. We're gonna leave it there. Obviously, a lot for everyone to think about, what you would do in that situation. Next, an undocumented immigrant and a pillar of